what my life would have been like if I did medicine. So what did you think of last week? Well, one of the many ways we find out, and one of the cheapest for the budget, is Twitter!
From Kieran O'Brien, at Wacky Aki, you shifted my sister! Hashtag not even mad, hashtag claim to fame.
What's that?
V News.
On the Voice of Ireland this week, Keane remembers his time in Westlife.
They were always singing. You know, it was another one of these typical Irish Vaughan traps.
Brezzy gives his thoughts on jokes in general.
I just don't get them.
A caveman stumbles onto set.
Mom. Aunt. Friend.
Budget slashed in Downton Abbey.
I bid you good day.
Cameraman struggles to get away from Owen's crappy attempt at consoling family.
That is bad news.
Somebody finally is asking the real questions.
Is there a big rap scene in Mayo?
Now, every single episode backstage has been looking at contestants' other abilities apart from singing. So I've elected to take this V-Report to show you the spin-off shows that'll never make it to air. Choker.
On Island!
Hat.
On Island!
I think we'll just stick with the Voice of Ireland for a while. First up this week, we have Chris Brady. Now, before Chris went on stage, he actually gave me a chance to see what it was like to be a contestant.
What major did
I think,
sing that song?
I was just motivated, like, you know, my fish died on my birthday and it was Christmas as well.
Who are your influences?
Keane Egan's right foot, Una's hair, just Rachel Stevens' entire existence.
But what was that song that he sang again?
I'm performing To Make You Feel My Love by Bob Dylan.
Nice.
I know a lot
nice.
Of people are thinking, no, that's Adele.
Oh, that Adele song. I mean, Bob Dylan song. Only I, the humble V reporter, could have made that mistake.
I love Adele, and I think that was a really brilliant song choice.
Keane was being a little bit harsh to his other male contestants.
He's definitely the best male on my team.
Don't feel bad about Colm and Joe and Stuart and the other lads on the team. It doesn't really matter. John O'Grady was backstage with me, and in great form, I must say.
Would you be partial to an old One Direction song?
Maybe do a bluegrass version of it. Oh.
Baby, you light up my world like nobody else.
He really did live the rock star lifestyle in the show The Night Joe Dolan's Car Broke Down. And he actually went into details as to how dirty some things got.
I've had the knickers on the stage.
Ooh, wouldn't I like to be sitting in that seat the next day. Kinyu sang a song for once and he was not going to let that go.
Who sang the song? Do you know the song? Rachel, who sang that song?
Was it Adele?
Next up we have Nicola Lynch, an incredible singer and rapper.
Annie, Tasha, Leon, Shauna Kennington and Josh Chin, Robert, Justin, Luke, Matthew, Maggie. John.
This leads me to my new segment called Here. What?
You are definitely one of the taller contestants we've ever had on the show.
Yeah.
Is exactly what I would say if that wasn't a lie. How tall are you?
I'm 4'9".
Oh yeah!
Here. What? They put her on a table. On a table! Why don't you just get a huge sign and write, "You're small"? But the gag doesn't end there. No, no, no. Enter Russell Hogg. Here. What? His height was compared with 42 people. They never did that to Hagrid. What is this tall shaming? And then Brezzy jumps on stage. Oh, the hilarity.
We were diving it all day.
You're huge. Take the heels off.
Producers across RTE high-five each other as they wonder, could this be a viral video? When Rachel stood up then, why did she say well done? She didn't even turn for him.
Well done.
Well done on hitting puberty and not smoking as a child. Doesn't make any sense. The man has had to live with people pointing out his height for years now. Then he goes on television, thinks he can escape it. It's all about the voice. Oh wait, no. Sorry, we'll just compare you to 42 people. Height.
On Island!
Oh God, I've just realized I'm part of the problem. Back to St. Vincent de panel again, and they've got Ellie Mae Bop this time.
When I heard Ellie Mae's voice, I was immediately just drawn to the voice.
Well, since you've your back to her, the only thing you can be drawn into is the voice. Unless you're like some kind of medium.
Her voice just entered me.
Backstage, I was hanging out with former hairdresser turned receptionist Mike Staunton.
You wanna wear nice your holidays?
I really enjoyed my time with Mike. Why didn't you turn? And he was going out with Vincent Van Gogh, for God's sake.
Today's support may I have my partner.
Vincent Van Gogh.
My niece Alana.
So we're looking at Rachel Murphy's family and friends, and it all seems pretty normal. Then bam, Ellie Goulding. Can't believe I met Ellie Goulding this week. Now, give the mic to Ellie, and let's just watch.
We don't have to worry about nothing.
Ooh, Ellie! Adam Cummins was the last person up tonight, and ooh, look, another one.
To impress the coaches, I hope to show that I have a large belt.
Belt.
Oh, Alan!
My God, these spin-offs are ridiculous. So, that's another week down. If you want to tweet me at RTE The Voice or at Wacky Aki on the hashtag RTE The Voice or facebook.com/The Voice of Ireland if you still like talking to your secondary school friends. As they say in French, bon voyage.